Or you can go with the less humane way, but super quick, and just go hunting for it. You know, this works. It seems to do the job. Hey guys, Seiji here. First off, thank you guys so much for 675 subscribers. It's absolutely a dream come true. So if you're not, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. It's free. You could always unsubscribe later, and it does help out a ton. Well, with that out of the way, we did a lot this episode. We ran a ton of vaults. We built a farm or two, and we even started crafting the best pickaxe you can get at this stage in the game. So stay tuned if you want to see that. But with that out the way, let's add a few comments to the wall. And yeah, you're seeing this right. We have an amazing piece of art by somebody super talented. We'll start with the comments. The first one is from Noah. I would love to see some building in the episode, like a time lapse or just a little here and there. Keep up the good work and I'll be sure to stick around. You're going to enjoy this episode because towards the end, we actually built a little bit on camera. Comment number two, we have Pat Crafter. Congratulations for 600 subscribers. Keep up the good work, King of Kelp. Also, please show us the start of the bounties as it's interesting to see what stuff you get. You're also going to love this episode because I showed a bounty and we completed a bounty. We'll add these right here, and then right here we have an amazing piece of art from the Thestormrider himself. And then we'll add the piece of art right here. If y'all haven't checked out the Thestormrider, be sure to check him out. I'll link him down in the comments below. He's an amazing artist and just super talented all the way around. And he's one of the people that actually got me into doing YouTube, believe it or not. So if y'all like my content, be sure to check him out and show him some love because he's one of the reasons I'm here. But with that intro out the way, let's hop straight into this episode. Also, subscribe. Alright, let's get into the episode. Hey everybody, how's it going? Today's episode, I want to rain a ton of vaults. But first, you might notice over here, I'm throwing stuff down, and that's all good. But when I put my magnet on, you just can't do it. So I'm going to show y'all how to fix that. So y'all have probably heard of the demagnetizer. Let me show y'all exactly what it does. It's super cheap to make. You could throw this down in your base pretty much wherever. And you can see when I throw stuff, I no longer have to worry about my magnet picking it up. And I find that super useful, especially like where your vault table is right now, until this can actually be automated. So I think a good spot for it right now is going to be right here. Not 100% sure on the actual range. It seems like it's a pretty long range though. But now to get some cod. So there's two ways you can go about getting them. So you can either fish some up with the fishing pole and hope you get lucky. We didn't that time. Or you can go with the less humane way, but super quick, and just go hunting for it. You know, this works. It seems to do the job. I mean, yeah, check this out. In a matter of seconds, we actually are up way more than we would have done just by fishing. I don't remember how many I needed, though, so I'll be back. So we should have enough cod, but we cannot forget the most important thing, the kelp. Now we can add these fish and go ahead and craft up this crystal. Nice. So the main thing I'm really wanting from these vaults is dreamstone. Oh wow, look, we got wealthy. The main reason is I want to make a couple more catalysts because currently I have a 2x plentiful crystal, and if I can get it to about 3 or 4, then all the POIs should be 100% ores. So what I mean by that is, you see how we have all this vault bark over here? Well, if you haven't, go check out Upbeat Snow's channel because he ran a 5x plentiful vault and this entire thing was full of vault ore. Oh, that was the last one we needed for our bounty. I completely forgot about that. We are getting so many coin piles this vault. Get away. And I honestly have not seen any dreamstone in the gilded chest lately. So I don't know if since they updated the loot tables, it kind of made a mistake on it. First monolith. Is this worth the 6 hearts? Not really. Oh, wait a minute. We just got an Eye of Ender from there. So let's try and take this portal on. It's going to probably be a mistake, but we'll see. So we're over here at this portal. I'm going to try to go through from the top because I don't want to get too many of those silverfish spawning on me. Y'all can already hear them. Okay, here we are. I know this is the baby way of doing it, but it seems like we got a trap straight off the bat. Well, let's actually get a montage of us opening all these chests. Well, that wasn't bad, but I kind of want to dig this way and see what that other structure is all about. So it looks like a library. I'm not going to go ahead and try to tackle it on because there's a ton of spiders down there and they can kind of hit you through blocks, it seems. Maybe it's just me, but since this new update, I have not gotten any dreamstone from gilded chests. I mean, yeah, look, I got 2 mystery boxes, but not a single dreamstone. So maybe the loot tables are a little wonky. I did not realize how low the timer was getting. I'm really hoping we can find our way back. We should just have to head east because there's that monolith that we got earlier. Super huge bummer we didn't get any dreamstone though, because I really want to get a couple more catalysts going with plentiful. All right, here's the portal, thankfully. So let's head back to the base and see what kind of loot we got. 4,000 experience is not too bad. I really want to see, yeah, 104 coin piles, which is absolutely insane. Let's claim that and see how much knowledge we actually got. Oh yeah, I did get a ton of hay bales from that villager room, so let's actually breed up some of our animals. 264 cows and 123 sheep. So now let's check out what we got in the pouches. 2-volt diamonds is not too awful bad, but the one I'm most excited for is the knowledge. Only 34. I figured we were going to get a bit more than that. We did get 2 mystery boxes though, so some gorgonite and some iron. Before I actually forget, let's put some feather falling on here because I just about died from fall damage in that vault. I added them to the wrong boot, yay. I meant to recycle these ones, and I was going to put feather falling on here. Thankfully, I have a few extra books. So let's retry that. Let's put some feather falling on here. I actually want to try to make a black chromatic iron pickaxe. I already have 1 ingot, and I should have enough black opal to make the other 2. The only problem is I'm missing 2 chromatic steel, so that's kind of a bummer. That just means we have to run another vault. You know what? We may as well add fortune on our pickaxe as well. Not going to hurt anything. But let's hop into yet another vault.
Yahoo!
Oh, an ice theme one. I don't know if I've actually had this yet. I'm sure I have. Typical Seiji for getting blocks. We got some leggings from there. That is absolutely insane. Anvil. Also, after further research, it seems like the dreamstone spawns at level 24 plus, so that's kind of a bummer. I'm seeing some sparkles team down there by the looks of it, I think, anyways. Oh yeah, some sparkle team. I'm so glad we added that fortune. We got 5 from that. That's insane. We forgot to claim our bounty. That's a bummer. Let's see what this altar chest had to offer. Oh my gosh, an epic plus item. That is absolutely insane. Oh my gosh, we found some Mamba Knight. We are getting a ton of ore deposits here. I'm not gonna complain because I actually really need the ores. Oh, we got a couple of ornate boys over here. Whoa, and by a couple, it looks like we have actually quite a bit. Okay, that one doesn't count. Most importantly though, we have a ton of anvils over here. Looks like we have 8 in total, so that should help me out quite a bit. Okay, this guy right here has a trident, so we gotta be super careful. Okay, we got him. We are finding a ton of ore deposits in this vault. That's insane. We even got a black opal, which is honestly the best. 2 black opal in the same vein, that is amazing. Wait, what? I didn't even know polar bears can spawn in this vault. So the Thestormrider is literally haunting me everywhere. Okay, awesome, we found another one. Just kidding. Oh, it was trapped. But we did get a couple ornate chests, which is honestly pretty good. Getting a ton of carbon, that's literally what we need currently. No gear though, but that's okay, we already have another piece. Okay, we need one more mob for this, and he's actually headed our way. Let's see what we get. Nothing crazy once again. A couple more living chests. Oh, and I see some Vopic Knight. Let's see how many we actually get from here. 3 of them. That's not too bad, honestly. 1 singular carbon. I think we have enough, honestly, to go ahead and make that pickaxe. I'm just hoping it doesn't break on us. Yeah, I said we play it safe and head back to the portal. Oh, you know what? I don't remember if it's chromatic steel or chromatic iron that we need to upgrade the pickaxe. Really hoping it's the iron. I really can't wait to roll up that idol. I don't think idols work the same, though. I'm pretty sure that you can actually die while holding them. Let's head back to the base and see what kind of loot we got. So we got 4,400 XP, and we opened a good bit of chests, 65 wooden ones in total. Let's clear this inventory up, open up our scavenger crate, and roll up this gear. So yeah, let's go ahead and claim this scavenger crate. We're going to get 2 pieces of gear, some leggings, and a helmet. Let's go ahead and open this bad boy up. Nice. So they're only level 14, but who knows, they may actually be better than these ones that we get. Let's see what we get. And some rhino leggings. That actually goes with the helmet, I think. No, okay, this is the dark rhino and these are the rhino ones. So looking over the gear, these pants are pretty decent, but these ones are just a bit better. The helmet is honestly the best thing that we got. Just a bit more armor, but it's gonna kind of suck losing out on that helmet. These pants are okay. And now let's check out the one and only. Okay, plus 6 mana and slowness cloud. Oh, hunger immunity is pretty good, honestly. So I wonder, can you just roll these up like everything else? We need plating. So we'll do a couple wild focuses and see what we get. Slowness cloud, not too crazy. I'm wanting something like that could help me in the vault. We'll go with this, the slowness, fatal strike, and mana. And I want to roll this helmet up a bit too, hopefully getting some extra prefixes for armor. Okay, right here is pretty good. The 11% mana regen and plus 2 armor is honestly insane. So that brings it from 27 to 29, but I'm back to being a scrappy boy. Wait a minute, I have an idea. We can make the transmogrification table. It costs 3 chromatic steel, and that's what I'm needing for that pickaxe. But we actually have 3 left over, which is the perfect amount. So should it be too bad, let's craft that up. Guys, please keep it down. I'm trying to make an episode. Wait, why are there so many? Oh my gosh, I bet they're attracted to the villagers. All right, that's the last of them. I'm gonna have to build an iron golem over there. But back to the transmogrification table. You can put this down and then pretty much get any gear that you want to put in my case, the helmet, a couple pieces of bronze, and you can change it to whatever models you've unlocked. Oh, I wish I could see what these other ones actually look like. So with a bit of bronze, you can select the helmet you want, do this, and now we're back to being the Omega Rhino. I was wondering why it was glowing and I put the wrong one on. Okay, well, I think we have everything for the pickaxe now, so let's craft up the rest of this black chromatic steel ingots. There's 2 there. And we should now be able to make A black chromatic pickaxe. This is going to be absolutely insane. As long as it doesn't break, that is. We do need chromatic steel ingots. Oh my gosh, what a bummer. Looks like we got to run another vault. First, let's grab a bounty though. Okay, this one's pretty good. Submit 65 chromatic iron to the table. We can actually do that now. Well, we got to smelt it first. Okay, this is all done smelting. We can actually go ahead and... How do you do it? Oh, okay, you just right click it. Flame that up. And let's open that bad boy up. We get a new axe. And it's scrappy. Not too crazy. We'll go ahead and probably recycle this straight away. And we actually got some of that alloy back. But as I was saying, let's run another vault. I actually want to rename these boots real quick. To the loot boots. I think this is a pretty cool name because they have a ton of item rarity and quantity. But let's hop into that vault. Oh, nice. We got a lucky vault this time. Sweet. Some gilded and ornate chest. An omega one. And we got a key piece, which is absolutely insane. Another omega. And we got a helmet this time around. Oh, you know what? There's husk in here and they gave us hunger. But if I put this bad boy on, no more hunger. Are you guys seeing that? That's some more Larimar. There are so many ore deposits in just this room alone. It's absolutely insane. Oh, I completely forgot creeper spawn on this vault, so I might have to be super careful with those guys. Yeah, I mean, look at all the ores we are finding. This is absolutely insane. So much Larimar. I would love to get some Xenium, though. Also, the goal with that black chromatic pickaxe is to try to get two sockets in it before it breaks, because then we could get the axing and shoveling jewel. Technically, we only need the axing one, so I might not be too greedy, and if I get one socket, just call it there. Oh, a couple ornate guys over here. That should be great. We might find some loot. No, but we're getting tons of carbon, and that's literally what we need. Can't forget the anvil. Another key piece, which is absolutely insane. I say insane a lot, don't I? I'm gonna probably have to find another similar to use. No way, guys. Okay, this is literally bizarre. That's a good one. Did I just Google similes for insane? Maybe. I'm gonna have to make a video with the title being Minecraft, but I can't say the word insane. It would probably be about a 15-second video. Another villager room. You know what this is, right? This is mad. Okay, that one did not have too much of a ring to it. We're gonna skip this village room, actually. Okay, a few living chests really aren't that bad because we do need knowledge so we can unlock create later on. Oh, we got an omega with a vault diamond in there. That is not too bad. Oh, also, always get these chest scrolls. They go for so much soul essence. It's not even funny. Oh, a couple more ornate with a lot more essence in it. Did I say essence? I meant raw carbon. Oh my gosh, this guy hits like a truck. This is an elite drowned. We're going to try to get rid of him the cheesy way to get that XP out of him. Oh yeah, that was way too easy. Or should I say way too cheesy? Yeah, I'm just going to quit talking after that one. Anyways, time's getting pretty low, so let's try to find the portal. Okay, well, there's our portal. So let's head back to the base and see what kind of loot we got. 6,200 experience is not too bad. I bet a lot of that was, yeah, from that elite drowned. Oh, we got a level up from that as well, so that's pretty cool. That means we can go ahead and unlock the strength that I've been wanting to get. Well, here's all the loot we got. There's a couple vault diamonds, and then the one that was, yeah, raw chromatic. Only 59, which is probably, what, about 6 of them or so that we should be able to craft up? Okay, 7. That's not too bad. That'll get us 3 ingots, and that should be at least one upgrade to this pickaxe right here. Sure was. And we got 1.3 speed, which is honestly a pretty good pull. Actually, it's pretty horrible. We can have up to 3. But let's roll this helmet up real quick and see what we get. And it's just a common. Yeah, not really too great. We're going to go and recycle that straight away. Okay, so you're probably wondering why I have a stack of pistons and a couple observers. Well, the reason for that is I want to go ahead and start putting some of the farms that we're going to have inside this place. So first up is going to be a pumpkin and melon farm. But Sage, I thought we were going to do kelp first. I have so much bigger plans for the kelp farm, so just stay tuned and wait for that. I'm going to be using the design I saw on Iskow's channel. It seems to be pretty good. So first I'm going to have to hollow out a bit of stuff over here. So we're going to add it right here in the corner, right off from the tunnel. But now I got to place some dirt down. So the melon farm that I'm using, I've actually never used before, but I am going to link the original creator down below. It starts off with digging 3 blocks in any corner that you want it to. So the third block would technically be this one. I'm going to place an andesite there. So after you dig those 3 blocks, you're going to build a 5-high staircase. Guys, I got a little bit distracted. What is this? Okay, so I could buy presents from this guy. You know what that means. Just wait right here, please. Really hope he didn't despawn. Okay, no, he's still here. Yeah, we're gonna just buy one of each. This one, we need some paper, so I wonder what that one's all about. Okay, let's open these all up and see what we actually get. Oh, I got a TNT in that one. Oh, so it's just random gifts. That's actually pretty cool. I wonder what this last one was. Okay, a couple fireworks. Not too bad, actually. I'm curious if it's the exact same gift each time. I guess there's only one way to find out. Yeah, it seems like it is. Well, thank you for wasting my emeralds. Well, this is what the staircase is going to look like. We have the 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. This is going to look pretty ugly at first, disclaimer, but once we get created, it's going to look a lot better. Then what you're going to do is come down to this third staircase right here, and you're going to put chest right next to it, just like this. You're either going to replace this one with a hopper. After the hopper, you're going to get a comparator, shove it right there, put a redstone torch here. Then you're going to come over here to the top, put a button right here. It does not matter the type, and a piece of redstone dust right here. Now you're going to start adding your rails. You're doing a powered rail here, and then just start coming down with your normal ones just like this. Once you get to a certain point, you are going to want to start having some powered rails like this. I dug below and put some redstone torches. You could do the same. And then basically just make a zigzag pattern coming all the way back and adding these powered rails down the middle. Once you get to this corner, you want to leave this last part blank because you're going to have to actually add rails coming from that way. Once you get to the end, it probably wouldn't hurt to add another powered rail somewhere here just to kind of gain the speed back up. Once you're right here, you're going to break this rail and break this one. You're going to then replace this rail there and then add this one here. That way it goes straight this way. And then once it comes back, it can loop back up here. For demonstration purposes, I went ahead and removed the dirt so I could show you what the minecart should do. It will then come back up here, and if it has items, it'll actually stop. Yeah, so I added some dirt in there. You can see that it's getting unloaded currently right here into this chest. Once it's all unloaded, it'll start going right back up. So I ended up having to extend these powered rails because it did not have enough momentum to go actually back up here in a four load. But with that part done, I can go ahead and add the rest of this dirt back. Once the dirt's placed, you actually want to start tailing in like a checkerboard pattern, just like this. And then you can start planting your pumpkins and melons. So when planting them, you want to alternate the pumpkins and melons on each row. And there's two different ways you can do these pistons. As you can see in the middle of my screen, I have that block there. You get that by pressing K, looking at the direction that you want it to be placed. For me, I just went ahead and added the cobblestone layer above, so it just makes it a bit easier on me. Now, all you do is place the piston above each piece of dirt. The next thing we're going to do using that same trick is come over here, and above each one of the actual crops, we're going to place an observer. Once all the observers are placed, you're going to put a piece of redstone dust on top of each observer like this. So in times, as melons and pumpkins start to grow, this will actually start automatically harvesting them. Yeah, just like that. You saw it right back there in that corner. We're going to put a glass border around here just so no extra pumpkins and stuff fall out. And we'll add some glass here so we can see the minecart go by. And like I said, this is by no means the best and prettiest build out there, but it's going to get the job done until we unlock Create. That's going to probably do it for today's episode. So sorry if it's a bit shorter. I have not edited yet, so I don't know the actual time on it. I really do hope you guys enjoyed the video. Sorry this one took a bit more time to come out than the other ones. I just got super busy with work. I would like to hear y'all's comments on how y'all's Christmas was or how y'all's holiday was. Mine was amazing. I got to spend the whole day with my wife and my child. It was probably the best Christmas I've ever had. Oh, we're going to buy this because next episode we may be able to run a cake vault. Anyways, leave some ideas down below on what y'all would like to see in the next episode. I would really appreciate it, and we are going to start working towards unlocking the Create mod. Anyways, I hope you guys have a great day. God bless you guys. Bye bye.